What's going on? I'm Tiffany Brown, and I'm super hyped to show you a little bit of behind the scenes to the Let There Be Love music video by Nat King Cole, created by me. Whatever. Let's get on into it.
Let there be you. Let there be me.
Wasn't that introduction just beautiful? Looking at some footage here, I actually, I began with the idea of a song by Heatwave, Always and Forever, but it was like a little too slow and I wanted it to be like a humorous love story type video. So Nat King Cole's like, the melody was just a bit more upbeat, and then also like that one pause in there that like had only instrument, I don't know, like it was just like a perfect pause for like something to happen like visually.
Let there be cuckoos.
Okay, so first, how did I get started with props and like the ideas I had and just everything with set wise? We're gonna look at some footage I have here. We got the boom box getting cleaned. That's gonna be a dope aspect in the video. Just these little details really important to just show a certain type of, I don't know, vibe in the video. Look how it's looking.
Double cassette, by the way.
This is like one of the baddest ones. Oh, yeah,
this was one of the baddest ones back in the day, for sure.
Love, love, love hearing like my dad's tangents about anything, going off into the boombox era or like movies.
Shout out to my cousin Dwayne Williams, DJ Dwayne Williams. Matter of fact, Dwayne Williams is the one on the far right. He was one of the first ones that had that box, had this box. Yeah, DJ. And his brother, shout out to the Noy.
Chinoy.
Shout out to the Alcoholics, the Liquid crew. He was dancing for the licks.
Oh my God.
D Batteries, okay. Do the Right Thing, when they killed Radio Raheem.
Oh.
You're talking about D Batteries. Learn to speak English first, all right? This is what you're talking about, these D Batteries.
20 D Energizers.
20 C Energizers?
D, not C, D.
Okay, so first things first, we have day one, the picnic scene.
She's getting the actors prepared, and they are late to set.
I love how she got this angle. I was over here ready to knock on the door.
I had wardrobe it earlier.
Looks good.
I told her what to wear.
It were taking forever to get ready, and this was 4th of July. This was in the summer, and it's currently December. But they were taking forever to get ready, and the light was changing every second. And I was like, why did I do it at this time? I was like stressed out. Yeah. Sister got some good behind the scenes shots. I'm over here tilting my head with it. I was kind of trying to get that angle. Let me see. These were different angles that I was getting. I had like an overhead shot. I was trying to go above them on this little stool. I really like those. And I tried to get like a going in. What is that? Like a, I don't know how dollies move, but like I just wanted a more of a revealing shot.
So yeah, you feel that? Yeah. Look at this camera lens.
Yeah, don't look
at this. Daddy, back up.
Wait, wait, wait.
So yeah, you feel that? Yeah. Look at this camera lens.
Yeah, don't look at this.
Daddy, back up.
You were dead. Oh my God, we were dying. No, okay, my dad was up here backseat directing. We need a gift from my, I swear. In this moment, I felt his breath on my neck. I was like, Daddy, back up. Let me talk to my mom. I was talking to her like, so what I want is you gotta look. He said, yeah, yeah, no, don't do that. You gotta look. He was repeating, I swear he was repeating the same stuff I was.
It's actually 4th of July, so it's hella stuff going off. Now we're gonna have a night shoot where we can have fireworks going off on top of them. So there's all these things that I'm thinking of and trying to go with. I don't know, I'm kind of hyped. Let's see how things go. This is only day one.
Okay, now we're going on to the bathroom scene.
Mommy, it's fine. I really don't have to worry about the mirror scene. He's like, it's gonna be okay.
Okay. Walk away and then just kind of drop lower. Like, ugh. Stop like that. Okay, we got to stop.
Day two. No food. She's working a sweatshop.
She's working a sweatshop. I separately shot my dad with like the him just getting reactions. I just like held the camera. My mom wasn't in it.
Oh, I like that one. That's nice. Yeah.
Okay, good. And then, so not too artificial. Do stuff you do in real life. I was like, okay, just give me different reactions of her walking out in different outfits. And then I had my mom, and we did shots like this.
Jumping. Woo, slam, slam.
So cute. That's the one. Okay, now we have day two, which is Costco shenanigans. We went to Costco.
We out in the streets with it today, y'all. I'm nervous. It's day three. Come on outside. Better lighting.
Yeah, the lighting.
Trying to go in Costco. Film, secretly film and stuff.
Way more. That's where the sun at.
Is the shade better?
Yeah, it's making the shade.
Thanks. Just supposed to be quick.
You're not be Simone. So stop.
I like the tone. It's shoot day three. We're going out in public. We're just going to see how it works. I'm just rolling with it. I don't even know how to feel. These people, they need to listen to me. They don't listen.
Don't worry, mama. But daddy, you're like, oh shoot.
Like, it was supposed to be like they're cramming, okay. Like they're crashing into something. Okay. So you're like, oh shoot, and you topple it over. So your face the whole time is like, I'm about to crash into something. My dad was stagnant. He was like, I'm like, okay, daddy, again, one more time.
We went to like this nice area with not lots of people. And then they're not really, employees, like I said, aren't really checking on you like that. And we had to stop a couple times because I want the shots with the mask off. And if we do shots with mask on, like, I don't know. Okay.
So stupid. Okay, and then now it's on to funny moments. Oh my God.
We're not a go yet.
Hey, you.
He said, hey, you. Wait, I need to ask him where that's from.
Hey, you. I've never done this before.
This is supposed to be a quick one. The Thomas acting.
Who's the sweetest of dumps? For the first time in my life, I see I need love.
So overall takeaways from those main parts, like I said, my energy, I have to get better on that if I'm doing like a big video and have a lot of people that I need.
Can I talk to you? Are you going to do my behind the scenes?
That hurt his feelings. Yes, that's what I'm doing.
My energy needs to be right. I need to stay joking, stay laughing, because then the people will stay light. Always keep filming, because always keep rolling. I don't know the term, because you'll literally, the fierest captures I had were not when I was asking them to do anything. They were just like laughing, or they were genuinely like fixing each other's hair, whatever. Like, it was perfect when I wasn't asking them to do anything. So I have to remember to keep rolling. That's something for next project, whatever it may be. Oh, that's the end. So God willing, there's more to come, and just in fun creations. So this is personally just a reflection for me, but if you're watching, thank you. And if you haven't gone to see the Let There Be Love video yet, it's already posted. You should go see it. Had lots of fun, and now you know what went behind creating that. So please share with others. I hope you enjoy, and I'll catch you next time. Peace.
Major shout out to the homie Breeze, aka Sunny Guns, LA Posse. You feel me? Muff. Shout out to the homie Hound, Dada, Tango DJ. You feel me? Larry Lope. The Twins, Big Sing. My whole boy Dave.